by vote. You can hear me, right? Let me know if I am not audible.
You're audible, Akshara.
Okay, Vaibhav.
I'm Vaibhav and I'm working on SAP payroll on premises already, having somewhere around 9+ years of experience in SAP implementation, AMS. Okay. Worked on around 9 to 10 projects as of now. Yeah, thanks.
Thanks for your introduction.
Thank you.
Madhu and Samir. Okay, let us wait for the people. Kiran, can you please introduce yourself?
Hi.
Hi, Kiran.
Hi. My name is Kiran, and I'm from Hyderabad. Yeah, I'm into SAP HCM since 4 years. So I'm planning to do this SAP HCM payroll, you know, EC payroll.
Okay. Thanks for the introduction. And then Kannan V has joined.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, hi. I'm also basically into SAP HCM, and I have around 10 years of experience, and I'm from Chennai.
Okay. And then we have Rakesh Kumar. Please introduce yourself, because before someone comes, we can have some chat over here.
Hey, this is Rakesh. I am from Gurgaon, and I am in SEO from last 4 years, more into payroll.
Okay. It's nice to hear. Madhu, would you like to speak? Madhu, Kiran.
So,
yeah, hi.
Yeah, my name is Madhu Kiran, and I have been working with one of the organizations situated at High Tech City in Hyderabad. And I have been in payroll domain from past 4 years. This is a brief intro about me.
Okay, thanks. Samir. Okay, just give me 2 minutes. We shall start if no one else is about to join.
Okay.
Okay, just let us see for 5 minutes more so that we can start it. Whoever join or may not join, I don't want to waste your time, your valuable Sundays. So in meanwhile, 5 minutes, please, if you have anything to speak, please speak, or if you want to ask anything, ask to me. Okay.
So what is the duration of the course, and like, is it on the weekly basis, like daily basis, 2 hours session?
Duration of the course will be totally 35 to 40 days. Okay, so this 35 to 40 days, each day 1 hour we will be taking, total 1 hour, because this is payroll. So total 1 hour will be with EC payroll, and every day session will be happening. And Sunday can be exempted due to people, you might have some things on Sundays to do. So Sunday can be exempted. Apart from Sunday, every day there will be one class, depending upon the time that we have and for all the people, which is acceptable also. So according to that, might be total 40 days.
Thanks.
Akshara, is it mandatory to do the EC certification before starting the ECP?
Actually, EC payroll is totally connected to EC. So all the data is being taken or integrated only from EC, Employee Central only. So whenever you want to check something in provisioning, you need to have certification in place.
So you mean to say it's mandatory?
Not mandatory, okay, but right. It will be useful to see provisioning. Apart, leave the provisioning. If you leave it to someone else and they are checking, you can go with the instance totally.
All right. And PCC configuration will also involve while we do the ECP training, right?
Will be compared. Will be compared, but not involved much, because this is, you know, the UI is different. So the user and experiences matters for the EC payroll. So which we have a great tool called one click monitoring. So we will be totally dependent on that tool.
So is it like more like a person having more like a payroll exposure? Is it going to help, or is just like somebody has more exposure to PC side has, what is more beneficial, more content in this training? Is like the payroll piece or more to the?
It is totally into the payroll only, but here and then we will be hearing the EC data, master data, you know, SAP HCM. So how you depend on master data to process the payrolls. So the same way here also, we will be depending on the EC. For the data, so here it will be like here and then, not totally into EC, it will be totally into payroll.
Okay. So this is a different certification than EC, is it, or it's
yes, this is a different certification, EC payroll certification. It is THR 812, I think, so code. THR 812 is the code of Employee Central Payroll Certification.
Okay. And not a must that one should know payroll before joining this course. I mean, is there a prerequisite?
It will be there, few prerequisites to understand the terminology. If you know the terminology before, I think nothing else is needed. So if you are familiar with terminology, understanding the terms, so if I say gross pay and net pay, you should know the difference between them easily. If you don't know the difference in between them easily, whatever I say, it will be just like a story going on. So just know that 1 to 2 terminologies, that will be fine. Later I will be explaining, I don't leave it without meaning to you what is the term that I am using. So it will be covered in the training.
Okay, I I heard about this, you know, ACP is completely on the on-premises of backend and SAP HCM. Is it right? Or?
Yes, it is almost right. The processing is being take place there, but the errors while we are doing and the process we start will be in EC payroll only. Most of the systems will be depending on this SAP systems, but the thing is here is the experience user while we are doing the payroll administrator while we are doing in EC payroll is different and there will be different. Process is there, but whatever errors or configuration, whatever it is, it will be in EC payroll only. Just processing is left to there.
So you mean in terms of waste types and processing, accumulation classes and processing classes, everything will be taken care of ECP?
Yes.
The calculation part?
Yes.
Okay.
But configuration is in ECP.
Okay.
Yes, I think we are done with almost the 5 minutes. So let me start. So sorry if I didn't take any one of your introduction. I will take your introduction after this session. Okay. And let me introduce myself. Myself, Akshara. So I'm certified in EC, Employee Centric, EC Payroll, and then Onboarding 2.0, and then Recruiting Management. So I'm certified in 4 modules and having expertise in SAP integration part. So I have 6+ years of experiences in all these things and in SAP HCM as well. So as part of my experiences, I have traveled across the globe with 2 to 3 countries to do the implementations with the client locations. And then with the client, I have many end-to-end experiences for implementations. So I have done up to now 7 implementation totally into SuccessFactors only. And EC is the one, and Employee Central Payroll, I have 2 in that. So likewise, I have many implementations as part of this SuccessFactors and SAP HCM. So, and I will be doing as the trainer. So I'm trainer from past 2 to 3 years for SuccessFactors, and I have trained many people. So hope I will send this batch also with a good knowledge outside and put your hands on experience into the system. So that is about myself. So just we shall start with the payroll. What is payroll? And we shall gradually increase what is the use of EC payroll, and then what the contents we are going to cover in this training, and what are the facilities you are going to get as a part of this training. So these are the things I am going to tell you in this demo. And if you have any questions after the session, please ask me, because as we have many people, we need to utilize the time now, and then later we need to have the query session at the end. Okay, so let us start with payroll. What is a payroll? Is a payroll is companies running the process to pay the employees when they have a list of employees that are entitled to receive pay and amounts that each should receive, that a company is having a payroll. So along with the amounts that each employee should receive for the time worked or task performed, payroll can also refer to a company's records of payments that were previously made to employees, including salaries, wages, bonuses, and then withheld taxes. So what a payroll contains for us is salary and then taxes, tax on the salaries, and then we will be having some other things like bonus. So salary is recurring for us. Every month salary recurs. That is recurring component. We can call it as recurring component. Bonus is non-recurring. It recurs only once in a year. If you have Diwali in place in India, you will receive a bonus which is non-recurring for us. So this is recurring and this is non-recurring. Tax also, it depends on the company's process we are following. So it depends on the things that a company takes. So recurring and non-recurring are the things here. So why I use these terminologies, coming up we are going to understand what is recurring and what is non-recurring. So bonuses are non-recurring and salary are. While you, for globally, if I take globally, salary is recurring component for across the globe. If across the globe, if you take any person, salary is recurring. But if you go for bonus, it is non-recurring. In India, it is Diwali bonus. If you go in other countries, they will be having bonus at the time when they have good profits, because most of the people, they don't have much festivals. So they might get for a year festival, 1 year once they will get a festival called Christmas. So it depends on the company's policies to give the employees bonuses. So we will be having a in-house payroll, or it will be given to outsource also. Payroll will be in-house or it will be given outsource. So one way that payroll can be handled is in-house for us. This means that a company helps all aspects of the payroll process on its own, including timesheets, calculating wages, and producing paychecks, sending the clearinghouse bills for any direct deposits. So what is the thing is here, the payroll process here, we need to, in this payroll, EC payroll, what we are going to see is timesheet as well. So integration of timesheet. So sorry, my keyboard is not working. So sorry for the inconvenience, because this quarantine I was also locked down at my home, unable to get it repaired. So EC payroll will be having timesheet integration to the payroll system. So this timesheet you are going to see as part of this training. So including timesheets, whatever the wages we have, whatever the taxes, and then whatever the reimbursement an employee has. So so let us take as an example, you have a team of 10 members. So for every quarter you have team lunch or team dinner. So you are going to your team lunch. So your manager has paid the bill. So manager has to reimburse it. Reimbursement. So he has to reimburse it. So when he will get this reimbursement is along with the payroll, we need to run this reimbursement as well. So that what it will be coming look like is salary plus reimbursement and plus and minus taxes, and then minus what else we can have other part of taxes?
The deductions like pensions or?
Yes, deductions. So like this will be calculated. That means manager reimbursement is added. So this will be a company handling the in-house or outsourcing. This is a process. Whatever we have to add to the payment, to the paycheck of an employee or to their payment, and then whatever has to be reduced. So these are the things that we cover there. So payroll, which is playing a major role in the internal operations of a business, so we will be having several reasons for this. So we will be having tax requirements depending on the country. So it differs from country to country, where we have different taxes. So the tax in India is different, the tax in US is different. So they will be having local regulations in the tax. So for few things we need to pay, for few things we need not to pay. So it differs from country to country what we having the payroll. And then we will be having frequency of payrolls in the payroll. So like bi-weekly payrolls will be running, or it can be semi-monthly. And then it can be monthly. Okay, so we have all these frequencies of payroll in the system. And then so let us see the terminologies we are seeing in the payroll. Components, we can call it as components here. So what are the components of the payroll? We will be having gross pay. So gross pay is the one which is with taxes. And then we will be having net pay, terminology net pay. And then we will be having other things like deductions. And we will be having garnishments, wage garnishments. So what is this garnishments is? Okay, sure. Wage garnishments is about the things that come across the paychecks. So the paycheck also includes the taxes. The taxes taken out of the paycheck are collected by the employer and then paid to their state or local governments. After the taxes are taken out of payroll, additional adjustments are made in the form of deductions, reimbursements, and garnishments. So any additional adjustments we have, they can be done in the form of garnishments, reimbursements, and deductions. So after the payroll is adjusted for different components, the final total that employee takes home is known as the net pay here. So net pay is the amount that employee gets to keep for themselves and spend however they see. So this is all about the payroll and the things, and let us see from our point of view what helps employee central payroll for us to process all these things with ease of use. So employee central payroll is a combination of proven technology and latest innovations and service delivery in a solution that represents the next generation of global payroll process automation. So it is just a good technology and is a good practice for everyone that goes with global payroll processes automation. So why the term automation is used here is, it's totally one click monitor. The greatness in EC payroll is one click monitor. When you are doing the monitoring, automatically the errors will be assigned to the particular admins. Whoever are the responsible, system will be assigning it. There is no another manual process that you need to assign those errors where you are monitoring the payroll process. And you can start with a button in the EC payroll to start the process of the payroll for the month or for semi-monthly. So payroll you automate and processing, which will reduce the risk and simplify the payroll management. Okay, the benefits of having this employee central payroll is, this is having a key features. Employee central payroll having a key features. So which is deeply localized with 40 plus countries. 40 plus countries are having the in-house payrolls which can be used for them. So when EC is introduced, it is supporting only some 20 countries. So only 20 countries EC has employee central SuccessFactors has supported. Now it is supporting some 50 to 60 countries. Now, likewise, when payroll is introduced, EC payroll, This has inbuilt capacity of 40 countries payroll can be customized in the system. 40 plus countries can be customized. So this has the full integration support with Employee Central and then time management and global benefits in SF. So off-cycle support and then retroactive payments and payroll processing for concurrent employments. So you know concurrent employment. So concurrent employment is a thing which is having a employee. So suppose you have an employee in your company, someone left a position in the company, but someone needs assistance from that position. Immediately a person who will be assigned to that, but he is already holding a position in the company. So he is holding two positions at a time, which is simply the concurrent employment. So leveraging of the proven SAP payroll engine. So this will be dependent on the payroll engine of the SAP. And we, from SuccessFactors, one more great thing we have is continual enhancements by innovative technologies. So we have payroll control center to make payroll professionals more responsive to the needed business. So most of you know that SuccessFactors releases updates every quarter. So this year it is half yearly. So in this half yearly, what they will be doing is giving us good enhancements. These enhancements will always develop the features in the system. So it will always strive to improve the system experience always. So this system experience every quarter, previously every quarter, now it is half yearly. So every half yearly you will get some 20 to 25 new features updates or existing feature updates in the EC payroll as well. That is what a continual enhancement by the SAP for us. And then real-time payroll monitoring is another thing we have from Employee Central Payroll. So for many businesses, the cost of human capital or payroll is the single largest expense. Payroll is also frequently the only regular touch point between an employer and the employees. This necessitates a timely and efficient payroll process that minimizes potential errors, offers us a regular process without errors. So what we are getting errors that will be minimized, and this avoids employee satisfaction issues. So you have been running a payroll in your company and you have some 100 employees. In these 100 employees, 99 employees this month got their payroll. One employee missed the payroll. What happens? It totally results in the employee satisfaction in the company. Okay, 100 employees got the payroll, but in one employee's payroll, there is an error. So some reimbursement is not added or some other, you have been deducted some more amount. So this all totally again depending on the employee satisfaction. In order to avoid all these, EC payroll will be giving us good overview and the new innovations in the payroll systems. So here the overall trend is to move away from the batch style processing to a continuous payroll process with real-time monitoring of payroll exceptions. Gone are the days when the payroll administrators have to spend significant time digging through the countless error logs, spools, reports, and diverse tech tools. So there are the days we have which we didn't have which we are always digging into the logs of errors in SAP and the reports or diverse tech tools we go through and find some errors and create some Excel and update there and update some lookups over there. So those are all needed, not needed here. So the error here will suggest you the solution. Error itself suggests solution in EC payroll. It will show where your system is failing in the error and what need to be added. So address plays a main part in payroll. So one employee missed their address, and while you are processing the payroll, so when you are monitoring, one click monitoring in the payroll control center, so when you are started, immediately four employees failed with errors. For those four employees, you can get into the details, and there you will be mentioned with the solution. Please add address to the employee. This is the reason why payroll is failing. So you will be getting a solution there itself, and you are going to there and add the address. The error is resolved. So you need not to go to the community and post your question, or you need not to Google something else which is different to you. So everything system is providing to you where the error is. So that is a robust process in EC payroll. The managers can in turn assign the errors to the payroll administrator is a flexible way. So we have some default rules here. And you know, you don't need to create some business rules here in EC payroll. So default rules will work. Default rules, so predefined SAP roles we have. So depending on that, these errors will be going, and the rules, business rules, which is having logic in the system, will be working automatically from the SAP. So there is no thing that you are searching for here and then and manually assigning the errors and telling to someone, please check the error, why this error is coming, or send it to other team, this is error from your end, or send it to EC and tell them this is error from you. The only thing is, two roles exist in the system. One role is payroll manager, another role is payroll admins. So payroll manager will be, what payroll manager will be doing is, payroll manager will be assigning the errors to the payroll admin. And whatever the errors he need to assign, he will be assigning them himself. So this is all the system process we have. So from the perspective of global payroll, it is an unmatched global capability for us from EC payroll. We know that payroll companies must think global but act local. Global refers to more than just a different language or name and address format. Local means more than just an aggregation of payroll providers. So global and local will be seeming the both. Even you go for a global payroll, what is the thing is, finally you will be end up in a local payroll. So I have a company. So the company is global. That means it is across 3 to 4 countries. Across these 3 to 4 countries, again, what they need to do payroll, for each country, they have to go again to local payroll. So across the globe, the local payroll is aggregation of providing the payroll providers. So localization will be having tax calculations to ensure that you are complying to no matter what country or region you are serving. And global will consider, local will consider the tax calculations only. What global will consider? Calendars with their local holidays. Correct. So calendars with their local holidays, time zones, because payroll has to be run on time. If some people get at different time and after 2 days some people get, it doesn't matter. Whatever you are processing this long and what are the efforts you put. When it matters is when you are processing it correctly on the last day of the month. And time zones, and then another thing is currencies. So the pay should be correctly checked if you are having a global payroll with these currencies. And the true measure of the local application is HR is a payroll engine. So there will be, so local will be totally tax calculations. Calculations will be dependent on the payroll engine. So when your organization grows around the globe, as you look for more visibility or control in specific countries, we will help make sure your employees get paid accurately and timely. So SAP will sure has a localized experts and knowledge to offer a global payroll platforms. So the best thing in SAP is one thing, it is giving timely support first. So if you have an S user ID, what you can do is you can directly open the support of SAP. So support.sap.com, open with your user ID, and you can check with an expert, payroll expert, with the thing that you are undergoing. So any configuration issue, you can ask them. Anything in the system issue, you can ask them. So they are ready to support us at everyday processes. Every day they will be supporting us with whatever the questions we are asking to the SAP people. So till now, we have many companies that have chosen SuccessFactors payroll, running SuccessFactors payroll. So this payroll is available to customers using the Employee Central solution. So it is clear that EC is mandatory to EC payroll. If you want to run your EC payroll in the cloud, first thing is EC has to be there in the system. And we will be having many operational challenges over this operational strategic aspects of HR. So you will be having the client requirements as well. Before going to the client, we need to understand the system and tell them what is possible, what is not possible. So these all things come under to us. So the best thing, if you want to go for an implementation of EC payroll, first analyze the system. If you analyze the system, when you analyze the system, you will understand what is existing with the system, what is not, cannot be done. And then when a client asks you, is this possible that I can do some changes over the payroll while it is running? Or can I get a notification when the payroll is completed? So this is not possible. So I have heard this requirement from one of my clients. They asked me like this, whenever a payroll administrator or payroll manager is starting the payroll processes, CEO has to get notified, CEO of the company, and any revenue people in the company has to get notified. A notification need to be sent. I told directly one thing, business rules are not possible in EC payroll. Business rule, there are no scope. Only things that run in the system is the existing defaulted rules by SuccessFactors to us. And they are predefined in the system. We no need to do anything on them as well. They will run on their own whenever we set up the configuration. So likewise, client will come up with many things in the system. They will be asking, this is possible, this is possible. Whenever we go to them, the only thing we need to do is understand and analyze the system and scope of EC payroll. Up to what extent the customization can be done. So we will be having a document for this. So SAP has released a document on the scope of EC payroll. As many one from the past 2 years, many people didn't even prefer EC payroll as they are scared to run the payroll in cloud. Now everyone is preferring to it due to the document they have released, the scope of EC payroll, which at what extent we can customize this, at what extent we can do this. So due to those things, the system has been good, and then client is preferring this system to run the payrolls. So SuccessFactors Employee Central Payroll is fully integrated with SAP SuccessFactors HCM suite, offering an end-to-end solution to help ensure that employees are accurately paid for the time recorded and based on their contractual obligations in this core HR system. So eliminating double data entry and ensuring accuracy. This is another point we need to clear, eliminating the double data or duplicate data, and then providing accuracy. So I think I can say this is the next generation payroll system, which will help us how we have a contrast between SAP HCM and then EC, Employee Central in SuccessFactors. We have many things which are quite different from them and the user experience. So it all in SAP, you will go through many transactions. Here we go through Googling it. So if I just log in, I think most of you people have seen it. So let me log in. So you need to go to the transaction code and then give the code and execute over there. The thing here is quite different, Googling it. So if you want to see some payroll related data, search for payroll in the search. So like a Google search, it will be showing the relevant things in the system. Click on that one and you will be navigated to the screen of the payroll system configuration. So let me select. So what are all the needed portlets for to maintain the payroll? So these are the things. If you prefer an employees from India, these portlets will be available for them. So we will be understanding what is a portlet here, because most of you won't be given, because EC has to be in the first place before the payroll. If you don't know, we can understand that. So ongoing, we will be here and forth with EC and EC payroll. So these are the things in the system. You no need to type some codes like PCAO or PA20, PA32, edit something, or it is direct a click away, take actions or make corrections or search. So everything is like a social platform here. So that is EC payroll, which is happening right now, and most of the clients are implementing in the system. So what are the contents that I will be covering for this training? Okay, after these contents, we will have the question sessions from your end. So we will be having Employee Central Payroll and Payroll Control Center. So topics. Topics that I will be covering is introduction of the Employee Central Payroll. Sorry for the inconvenience again. Employee Central Payroll, and then discussion over the Payroll Control Center. And then we will be seeing the user access. So I will be sending the training contents document again, but for your knowledge, I am saying it here. So user access. So what is the possibility for an people to have the accesses? So which will be like RBP, role-based permissions. Here, what are the HR admins permissions? What is the payroll admins permissions? What is payroll manager permissions? So we will be discussing over in this chapter. And then discussion on the employee data, which is most important to run the payroll. So in this, as part of this, we will be discussing add new employee steps. If you don't know, add new employee steps. So adding a new hire employee and how the employee data is processed. And we will be discussing about the data replication. Data replication, which will be through data replication monitor we have. So data replication will be discussed over here. And then updation of the employee's payroll data. Okay, this will also come under the employee data. So here we have seen the payroll control center, and now this will be like an introduction part to the payroll control center totally, because without few things we cannot totally go into the system. So then we will be again having another payroll control center user interface discussion, control center UI. So user interface. Indeed, what we'll be covering is how the payroll process and any alerts, and then drop downs, one click monitoring before the pre payrolls, analysis, alert resolutions. So with the three click production payroll, and then production payroll running, off cycles. So we will be discussing here. And then we will be covering the employee data we can cover, and then transactions in the employee central. Employee central transactions. Employee central transactions, and then employee self-service and manager self-service in SuccessFactors. So these are all totally, I'm talking about SuccessFactors. Few things in the payroll control center, we will be looking into SAP HCM as well. So MSS in the SuccessFactors, and then data changes that happens in the system. Data changes will be discussed, and we will be discussing localization. So localization of, I think it is fine if we go with Indian payroll to everyone. Okay, we shall discuss on that one, what payroll we need to see. And we will be seeing some workflow approvals. So these are the total topics that we are going to cover as part of this. The most thing that covers here is payroll control center. Payroll control center having 70% of configuration. Rest of the 30% is with other things here. So without even 1%, we cannot process the payroll, you know it well. So that is the reason why these are the topics that we are going to cover. And these topics will take 35 to 40 days. And the training will be, so from my end, what are the facilities you are going to get? Now, these are the contents of facilities from our end. Demo system to practice. And then topic-wise document, daily topics. And then Employee Central guide. Guides along with integration guides. What is the thing here is we can integrate third-party attendance systems to Employee Central payroll if you are not having time off in place in your system. So if you take example workforce, it can be integrated to EC payroll. If you take Cronus, it can be integrated to EC payroll. So according to the third-party system, we will be having integration guides. Or if you are going with timesheet in EC, so it is not timesheet in EC, totally this timesheet is only for payroll. So we will be having a document of the integration to the timesheet. So I will be providing you the total guides of all this. And then daily task to practice. You need to practice the task and come up with the doubts next day. Or if we think that we cannot ask the doubts in the session as we are having less time to complete the things, so you can do one thing. You can mail the questions to me that I will reply to you. So I will be replying all your questions and all your doubts via mail. Or if you want to clarify in the call, just wait at the end of the call. Then everyone is interested to listen to your question, and when everyone has time, I will be explaining. If anyone don't need, they can leave the session. So that is the thing about the task. You need to practice the task and come, or else we cannot move further in the topics as well. So after the task, certification assistance. Certification assistance. So this certification assistance will be given. The similar questions will be appearing in the exam as well. So you can get in clear overview over there. What type of questions are coming and how much percentage questions are coming. So if you want to have, you can have the certification assistance. That's your choice. And then another thing is mock interview. If you want, I can take a mock interview for you after the training one. Before training, I cannot take mock interview, which is optional. If you choose to, you can, because most of the people who comes for training, they will ask for these only. So that is the reason why we added it here. So these are the things we are going to provide you. And the only thing you need to do is practice a task and come to the class. That is only request from my end. So I will be giving you a system without restrictions. I will never say, don't do that, don't do this, why you did this. Do whatever you want in the demo system. Practice how much you can, come up with questions to me. We shall go into deeper discussions. And if I am also not able to solve, I can raise it to SAP why it is happening like this. Okay, so these are the things from my end. So I think I can justify for what you are going to get in the training, what you are going to pay for the training. I want to give you a justification without, not that you just come and go. I don't want in this case of training. I want you to deeply involve in the training and get justified for what you have spent from your pocket. Okay, so now let us have the question session. Please start.
Hi, this is Rakesh. So I have a couple of questions. So regarding, as you mentioned, there's integration with Kronos. So like how the integration works is like some kind of file need to be generated in a format from the Kronos and getting uploaded in the SuccessFactor EC payroll or SuccessFactor Employee Central. And is it like frequencies there? I'm just not over the Kronos. I just give an example. And in SCM system also we have like CATs, right? Or time, timesheet systems and also. Is it also integrated with based on the files or some kind of mechanism to EC or Employee Central?
No. No files are used here to integrate. If you use files, that is manual, right? So if you are going with manual, that is nothing with integration. So we have integration in place, which will be integrating the systems. Your SuccessFactors system will be integrated with Kronos, or that will be integrated with SAP. But before you are going to implement EC payroll, EC is mandated. If EC is mandatory, your time of timesheet will be in EC totally, and it will be picking from here. Okay, if your client have a different scenario, he want to have EC, but his time system is different. He has another third party client system. In that case, have EC here, then EC payroll, then integrate your time system with EC payroll. It's clear.
Okay. Yeah, so we have a, we can integrate the other time system with the EC payroll. So do they have integration with SAP SCM time system?
That is the thing I am telling. CATs, no.
Yeah. Okay. So when, and is like a system, so where the data will come and sit? Do we have data model defined in the payroll, or where the data will be processed while in the payroll, right? That's my understanding, is correct?
Data model is from EC. Yeah. And EC payroll, whatever the configuration you are doing, that configuration will be added to the data models of EC.
EC, not in the...
there are no separate data models for the payroll.
Okay.
So whatever the data models exist for EC, the configuration we are adding to those data models.
Okay, and okay, and but there's a okay, so there's an inbound and the outbound, right? When I'm a hiring employee, I need to send the data to third-party time system also from SAP PC. Sorry, that's okay. So there's also integration for that. The second question is some client have like net payroll and the gross payroll, and they use ADP or some other third-party tool to send the data. So is it the hybrid is feasible or possible with Employees Central?
It will be feasible with the EC payroll, and if we have any other data that is related to EC, that is feasible for EC also. Suppose you have some fields from ADP, need to get over to Employee Central, and then it should be updated to EC payroll, means we can have integration. So we have a good HCI, which is HANA Cloud integration, which will be helping us to integrate with other systems, so which is the provided thing from SAP for us. So from that, what we will be doing is mapping. Most of the things when you are doing integration is mapping of the fields from one system to other system. So if you take SAP HCM and integration with the SuccessFactors EC, what happens is mapping, which is BIB, Business Integration Builder. Likewise, in any other systems while we are integrating, we will be having those mappings in place, and then connections, end-to-end point URLs will be connected. Okay.
And the reporting of the payroll, so some the way we have like waste type reporter and all in the SAP payroll, right? So all the reporting will happen from SAP EC payroll?
Yes, it can be happened. We have a separate platform called reporting for it.
Okay. And do we need to also maintain some configuration or customization in ECC? No, right?
No, no. Okay. Configuration is totally here. Process engine is over there. But what one thing is, we need to maintain the same data, and data should not differ from SAP and EC systems.
The PCR and the schema should be modified here, or should be modified. Should be modified in EC payroll, or should be modified in SAP if there is some change needed, right? Based on the client.
Yes. They will be in SAP. We are modifying over there. PCRs we are going to run.
So in the as you mentioned, the weightage of the questions in the certification. So the most of the questions come from the payroll, or payroll EC payroll configuration, or is it more they ask questions related to EC itself, that how to hire an employee, how to maintain, example like info like it.
Actually, we have a blueprint for the questions. So total 100% of questions. Out of that, 12% from the topics. Topic wise percentage will be mentioned, so that according to it you can practice the things.
Do we have any guide for EC payroll, or?
Yeah, we have. We have guides for EC payroll, scope of EC payroll, integration of EC payroll.
Okay.
Like this, we have every guide in place.
And which will be shared by the training, right? If I'm not wrong.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, let me allow to ask others. Allow others to ask the questions.
Yes. So, any others having any other questions?
Hi, Akshra. This is Shri. I just wanted to know, like, when we say EC payroll, is it almost same with the SAP HCM payroll doing in the SAP system, or like when you're saying PCRs and schemas, right? So are we having the same like PCRs and schemas in EC payroll?
We have the PCRs and schemas, but only these things are in SAP we are doing. Rest of the things configuration are done in Employee Central payroll, but the systems are very different. Once you see the systems, you will understand what is a great thing that this has been introduced for the users or HRs who are doing the payroll processes or payroll administrators. So we have most things like one-click monitorings or production payrolls or error assignments. and solutions to the error assignments without having error logs from SAP. So these all things are great things that we have, and accuracy things which will not leave one employee behind while we are running the whole payroll process. So it is quite different for you to what I can say is you can easily understand Employee Central Payroll than SAP HCM.
Hey, this is Samir here. I had one question.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Just clarify that this one, the processing, the payroll driver will always reside in the S4 side of it or EC side of it, and the execution will happen here, right? Like that it is, or how?
Yes, you are correct. It is like that happening. Payroll drivers will be in the S4 side, and then data is will be maintained in EC side, and processing is done is on the SAP.
Okay.
Any other questions, Samir?
No, you can carry on.
Yeah.
I have a question. Yes. You're saying SAP, we will be having SAP, like PCS and schemas in SAP, right? So my question is here, when we have the EC payroll, as you said, EC we should have, but my question is, do we need to have the SAP system also or not required completely?
So we need to have SAP finance systems also for this. So it depends on the client requirement. So I think no company will be existing without SAP to run the payroll till now. So they will be having SAP payroll, or if they don't have the third party system payroll, that can be integrated to EC payroll.
So I understood the first part, if the client is already a payroll client and having the SAP payroll system, if they are upgrading, so in that scenario, they will be having it. But my question is, if the client is completely new and they didn't have the SAP payroll system, and first time if they are going for the payroll, then still do we need to have it?
Yes, we need to have, because the payroll process is doing in SAP, right? Process is in SAP, but configuration and whatever doing is, we are not having SAP HCM in place to configuration. We are using Employee Central Payroll to configure. That's it.
So still the data flows between SAP system and the BizX system?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So are we saying that info type 8 configurations and those things need to be maintained in FCM also? Okay, got it. So it's pretty much is like an integration that we are using to have everything in FCM and running the payroll from the EC Employee Center. Does it make sense?
Even you are going to implement S4 and you implement the payroll control center there. So it is the same concept kind of thing, right?
Yes. So someone is in between. You are asking something.
So, and coming to the time management, you're saying, like, if the client is going for like both the positive and negative management, do they need to have the SAP system still, or can the EC accommodate all the scenarios?
Sri, I think you have joined in the middle. I have already clearly mentioned that if you have EC, it's good to have directly timesheet and time off in the EC itself. EC will be having this time off and timesheet configuration, which will be containing both positive and negative configuration that can be used for payroll. So this is the thing I have told you. So if you have EC, it is good to have time off and timesheet. If you are maintaining another time system, then it is no need to have this time off and timesheet here. We can use that system to integrate over here. So that is the thing here. So no need to always go to SAP. What I am telling you, what should be done in SAP is only the payroll process engine and PCRs, except that everything we need to do in our cloud system only.
Okay.
So any other questions from anyone?
Yeah, other than this general question, what is the best time for you to take this session?
So we have many people all here, so it will be good to have the major opinion and then have my available time in place. So we will be discussing it and letting you know. So you tell me, what is your available time?
I mean, I need early to this session because this is night for me. So if we can have this couple of hours before, then it would be like your 7 o'clock or 6:30. It will be fine to me.
Okay. We shall discuss.
And same here also, this is Rakesh. If we can have like a little bit early, around like 7:30, okay. That will be a good fit for me.
Okay, considered your opinion. So any other concerns from any people?
Daily 1 hour session or 90 minute session?
It's 1 hour session. It extends when needed up to 90 minutes.
Okay.
Hi, Akshara, Madhu here.
Yes, Madhu.
I have one query. So I have been associated with payroll since last few years. So I have been worked with, too many third party applications like Paychecks, ADP, Cashflow, some other kind of applications. In those applications, they used to provide employee self-service portals to access their employees' pay slips and their year-end reports. Likewise, in EC also, there is such option where employees can exercise rather than depending upon the employers for their pay slips and other stuff.
Yes, we can integrate, and then we can have one great thing is we have tiles over here, which will be redirected us to the following portlets or things or any other things in the any other systems. So which will be helping us to navigate to the following things, and then we can access them.
Okay. And one more query I have, the reports generation. So in SAP EC payroll, there is a flexibility to customize the reports as per the management requirements, or the reports are like default reports only we can generate?
So we have ORD in place, which is online report designer. So what you need to do is you need to design the reports. Customization.
Okay.
So customization, it will be helping us. Yes, it will be helping us, but not to the full extent. It is to the, there will be having some features. To that extent, we can get it in the ORD.
Okay.
So any other question?
Yeah, 1 minute, Samir here. Sorry to interrupt. So this you're talking about India payroll to be taken up in this. So once you implement this EC payroll in for India payroll and all, so the statutory reports and all like Form 16, Form 24, and all other things, are they ported to EC payroll or they are still from the back end?
So Form 16 and all will be from the back end only.
Okay,
these are localizations, so we need to have them in place. So these are from backend.
So does this mean that all the localizations that are whatsoever, like US payroll or any other country, Europe or some other country payroll, so all these forms and all still will continue to be backend? Is it correct?
Yes, but I cannot say it will be surely there, because we are in another 1 month, we are going to get another update. So happy yearly
update.
That is understood. Yes. Yeah. So they will be, might be most of the enhancement request in EC payroll is regarding these forms and localizations only. So I hope they will be releasing these new update features to EC payroll.
Okay.
Yeah. Vaibhav, you can ask.
Yeah. So ORD is from is for the operations perspective, isn't it? It's not like a BAP. Is that correct? Right? Like a framework tool,
it's
right?
It's not for the BAP. Yes, it's a framework tool. But no, what happens in the ORD is we are going to design something which is out of the things that we have. So it is great that if you can get the processing details in ORD, we are getting those details. And okay. ORD is totally will be giving us analytics also. You can compare the data, you can see how much percentage of the data.
All right, so it's similar to like, you know, the query SQ01, SQ02 and yes. SQ03, right? All right, okay.
Totally, it seems like SQL for us.
All right, so it's more like a framework given to the operations team to design the reports based on their needs. But if you have any specific custom requirements, then it would be a BAP, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
All right, the time will be probably going to be an issue for me. I woke up around 4 o'clock today.
Okay, we shall discuss this, Vaibhav. That is a constraint I was considering everyone's time. So I will be checking and letting you know. I won't make anyone trouble in this session, okay?
All right, thanks, yes.
So any other questions, guys? Or else we can close this session and we can decide the things and we can start our trainings further. So if there is no questions, please, you can leave. If you have, please stay back. It seems no one having questions. Okay then, so have a great day, everyone. Great Sunday, this quarantine Sunday, enjoy with the family. So we will be, if you decided on the training, please let me know. But I hope I want to see everyone in the session because you are asking some constructive questions to me, which I need to also have good constructive knowledge over that. So this will help me to learn and this will help you to learn also. So I hope to see you everyone in the training soon. Thanks for your time. Have a great Sunday. Bye.
Stay safe. Cheers. Bye.
Yeah. Thanks very much.